Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a complete course for the CCNA. In this video, we will cover a topic related to virtualization, that is containers. Containers are similar to VMs, virtual machines. However, there are some key differences that you must understand. If you are interested in the field of DevOps, you will have to learn containers in depth. For the CCNA, however, you only need to understand the very basics. Here's what we'll cover in this video. First, we will review virtual machines. Containers are a similar technology to virtual machines, so it's important to understand both so we can compare them. Then we will look at containers. You may have heard of Docker before, the most famous container engine available. Finally, we will spend some time comparing virtual machines and containers. To begin, here's an example of apps running on a server without virtualization. There is a single operating system, for example, Windows Server or Red Hat Linux, and on top of that OS, all of the apps are running. The apps are not isolated. A problem in one app could affect all of the other apps. Now, you could isolate them by buying a separate physical server for each individual app, but that is extremely cost inefficient. Virtual machines are a solution to this problem. Virtual machines, VMs, allow multiple operating systems to run on a single physical server, and then apps are installed on those operating systems. A hypervisor is used to manage and allocate hardware resources to each VM. Remember, the VMs are all running on top of the same physical hardware, so they need a hypervisor to allocate those resources appropriately. There are two main types of hypervisors. Type 1 hypervisors, also known as native or bare metal hypervisors, run directly on top of hardware. That is the top diagram. Notice the Type 1 hypervisor directly on top of the hardware, with each VM then running on top of the hypervisor. Type 2 hypervisors, also known as hosted hypervisors, run on top of a host OS, for example Windows or perhaps Mac OS or some kind of Linux. That is shown in the bottom diagram. On top of the hardware, there is a host OS, with the Type 2 hypervisor and its VMs installed on top of the host OS. Type 1 hypervisors are widely used in data center environments. If an enterprise has servers installed in a data center and is running its apps on VMs in those servers, you can be sure those VMs are running on a Type 1 hypervisor. Type 2 hypervisors, on the other hand, are commonly used on personal devices. For example, running a virtual network lab on your PC using Cisco Modeling Labs, CML. For my personal studies, I use CML to run virtual labs. Windows is installed on my PC hardware, I run VMware Workstation, a Type 2 hypervisor in Windows, and then CML runs as a VM in Workstation. Note that the OS in each VM can be the same or different. If you are running multiple VMs, one can be running Windows, the other Linux, and the other Mac OS. That's no problem. The binaries and libraries that I have indicated in gray in the diagrams are software libraries and services needed by the apps running in each VM. A VM allows its app or apps to run in an isolated environment, separate from the apps in other VMs. If there is an issue with one app or one of the guest OSs, it's not going to affect the others. And VMs are easy to create, delete, move, etc. For example, a VM can be easily saved and moved between different physical servers. Here's a very simple diagram to help you visualize the difference between Type 1 and Type 2 hypervisors. Type 1 runs directly on hardware, and Type 2 runs on a host OS. Virtualization using VMs allows much more efficient use of server hardware, and VMs are widely in use today. However, containers are a more recent virtualization technology being used more and more in recent days. Let's move on to the main topic of today's video, containers, and then compare them to VMs. This diagram shows the basic architecture of how containers run. Containers are software packages that contain an app and all dependencies, the binaries and libraries in the diagram, for the contained app to run. Note that multiple apps can be run in a single container, although this is not how containers are usually used. you can generally assume that one container means one app. Containers run on a container engine, for example, Docker engine, which is the most popular one. And that container engine is run on a host OS, usually Linux, which runs on the hardware. Containers are lightweight and include only the dependencies required for the specific app. No need to run an OS in each container, unlike in VMs. That is the major difference between VMs and containers. VMs run an OS in each VM, whereas containers don't. All of the different costs and benefits of VMs versus containers come from that major difference. Now, a container orchestrator is a software platform for automating the deployment, management, scaling, etc. of containers. For example, you might have heard of Kubernetes, which is the most popular container orchestrator. Docker also has one called Docker Swarm. Now, why would we need a container orchestrator? Well, in small numbers, manual operation of containers is possible, but large-scale systems, for example, involving microservices, can require thousands of containers. That many containers cannot be realistically managed manually. Since I mentioned microservices, microservice architecture is an approach to software architecture that divides a larger solution into smaller parts, called microservices. So instead of one monolithic app, you might have hundreds of different microservices running together to form the larger solution. And those microservices all run in containers that can be orchestrated by Kubernetes or another platform. So that's a very quick overview of containers. Now let's compare VMs and containers. As I mentioned before, these differences all stem from the fact that each VM runs its own OS, whereas containers all run on top of a shared OS. That major architectural difference has some implications that make containers favored in many cases these days. First of all, VMs can take minutes to boot up, whereas containers can boot up in milliseconds. This makes containers much more agile. For example, if one container crashes, it takes very little time for another to boot up and take over. And VMs take up more disk space, often tens of gigabytes, whereas containers usually only take tens of megabytes. Again, that stems from the fact that each VM includes its own OS, whereas a container only contains an app and its dependencies. And for the same reason, VMs use more CPU and RAM resources compared to containers. Regarding portability, VMs are quite portable and can move between physical systems running the same hypervisor, but containers are even more so. They are smaller, faster to boot up, and Docker containers can be run on nearly any container service. So with these points, containers are looking much better than VMs, but VMs do have their advantages. One advantage is that VMs are more isolated because each VM runs its own OS. An issue on one OS won't affect apps in other VMs. However, that can't be said for containers. If the OS all containers run on top of crashes, the containers are all affected. Note that this isolation also provides security benefits for VMs. To summarize, there is a major movement toward the use of containers, especially with the rise of microservices, automation, and DevOps, which is the combination of software development and IT operations. But VMs are still widely used today, and they aren't going to go away anytime soon. The discussion of VMs versus containers has been had many times online. Do a search on Google or YouTube, and you'll find lots of resources if you want to learn more. Here's what we covered in this video. First, we briefly reviewed virtual machines, and then we covered containers and compared them with VMs. Containers and VMs are similar, but also different in key ways. There is, of course, a lot of depth to the topic of containers, Docker, Kubernetes, etc. For the CCNA, you should just know the basics I mentioned in this video. But if you're interested in learning more, there are countless resources available online. Okay, let's go to the quiz. Here's question 1. Identify the 3 components below that containers run on top of. Pause the video now to think about the answer. Okay, the 3 components are the hardware, the OS, which runs on top of the hardware, and the container engine, which runs on top of the OS. Then the containers all run on top of the container engine. Okay, let's go to question 2. Which of the following are examples of container orchestrators? Select 2. Pause the video now to select the answers. Okay, the answers are B, Docker Swarm, and C, Kubernetes. They are both popular container orchestration platforms, although Kubernetes is definitely the most popular. Docker Engine is a container engine which containers run on top of. It's not an orchestrator. And Hyper-V is a Type 1 hypervisor by Microsoft. It's not related to containers. Okay, let's go to question 3. Which of the following statements about VMs and containers are true? Select 3. Pause the video now to select the best answers. Okay, the answers are A, C, and F. VMs require more resources than containers, because each VM runs its own OS. VMs are more isolated than containers, again, because each VM runs its own OS. Containers, on the other hand, all run on a host OS, with a container engine installed on top of it. Okay, that's all for the quiz and this video. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. Before finishing this video, let me thank my JCNP level channel members. To become a member, please click the Join button under the video. Thanks to Jonathan Makara, Velva Jacob, George Streeter, Funny Dart, Nasir Chowdhury, Devin Suku, Gustavo Biar, Gerard Baker, Marcel Lord, Pavel M., Mr. Erlison, Dragos Hirnea, Zakib Shah, Mare Salman, Mazen Anderson, Vitaus194, Gina Lindley, Nahemia, Justin Watke, Mark Jackson, Bold1C1U, Michael Carroll, Gerald Guillaume, Gabriel Braga, Renan Marias, Hector Hernandez, Ali Polat, Maratuba, Roji Kuriakos, Arpad Konives, 5 Feet, Daniel Brown, Tricky Mickey 123456, Scott Thompson, Jose Alvarez, Kevin Hayes, Hussein Yavuz, Samuel Tavares, Mustafa Ersoy, Dear Diso, Nasser Zahar, Alexandru Badic, Brian Grant, Georgi Yemejev, Ahmed Ismail, Dibia Swain, Tan No, Arlen Plagaria, Adelson Pereira, Abdo Zizo, and Farad69. Sorry if I pronounced your name incorrectly, but thank you so much for your support. Thanks to you and my other supporters, I am able to make these videos and release them for free on YouTube, so I really appreciate the support. Another great way to support the channel is to like the video, leave a comment, subscribe, and most importantly, share this video with others. So, if this video was helpful, I'd appreciate it if you did any of those. Thanks for watching.